Up to now, we have learned how to compare the two-digit numbers and how to write the how to put the symbols less than, greater than, and is equal to between two numbers, and how to write the ascending order for the given set of numbers, and also we have learned how to write the descending order for the given set of numbers. So now let us go to the next topic in this chapter. It is numbers on the abacus. So numbers on the abacus. So children, what is abacus? So abacus is a device which with we can represent any number on the abacus. So abacus is a machine which is used to represent the numbers on it. So how the abacus will be? So children, so observe the abacus. So in abacus there will be spikes. So there will be spikes. That means the rods, the small thick rods are called spikes, and there will be so one spike for each place. So that means for one place there will be one spike, and for 10 place there will be another spike. That means for each place there will be each spike on the abacus, and we can put the beads. So these are called beads. And by using these beads and by keeping these beads on these spikes, we can represent the numbers. So with the help of these spikes and beads, we can represent the numbers on the abacus. So children, look at the screen. We can show a number on the abacus. To show 79 on abacus, we put 9 beads in ones place. That is in ones spike, and 7 beads in tens spike. So children, how can we represent numbers on the abacus? So first, so let us see an example. So the number is 79. So how to represent the number 79 on the abacus? So children, this is the number 79. So 9 is present in ones place and 7 is present in tens place. So in abacus, there will also be 2 spikes. So this is a 2-digit number. So that's why there will be 2 spikes. And one spike is ones place and one spike is for tens place. So this is called ones place spike and this spike is called tens place spike. So now how can we represent? So here, so there will be so 9 in the ones place. Now we have to keep 7 beads. We have to keep 7 beads on ones spike. We have to keep 9 beads on ones spike and 7 beads on tens spike. So in this way, by using these spikes and beads, we can represent any number on the abacus. So let us practice some more problems on the abacus by entering into some activity part. So let us enter activity part. So children, so this is some activity part on abacus. So now we have to represent, that means we have to write numbers from the abacus. So write the numbers shown by each of the following abacus. So children, so there are given some abacus and there are also they have kept some beads on each spike. And by counting the beads on each spike, we have to write the numbers from the abacus. So let us see how to write the numbers from the given abacus. So see the first abacus. So children, so in this abacus, there are 2 spikes. So this is, O means, this is ones spike. That is ones place spike. T means, this spike is tens place spike. So children, so how many beads are there in tens spike? 1, 2, 3, 4. That means 4 beads are there in tens spike. So there is 4 in the tens space. And how many beads are there in the ones spike? 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 beads in ones spike. That means 3 is present in ones space. So 4 is present in tens place. 3 is present in ones place. So the number is 4, 3. That is 43. So next, children, see the next problem here. Here also they have given abacus and they have keep some beads on each spike. There are two spikes in this abacus. So O means this is a once place spike. T means this is a tens place spike. Now we have to count the number of beads in each spike. So let us count the number of beads in tens spike. How many beads are there in tens spikes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That means 9 beads are there in tens spike. That means 9 is present in tens place. And how many beads are there in ones spike? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 beads are there on ones spike. That means 8 is present in ones place. So 9 is present in tens place and 8 is present in ones place. That is 9, 8, and this number is 98. And see the third one. So see the third abacus here. So here also two spikes are there. So this is ones spike and T means tens spike. And how many beads are there in tens spike? So let's count the number of beads on tens spike. 1, 2, 3. There are 3 beads on tens spike. That means 3 is present in tens place. And how many beads are there on ones spike? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 beads are there on ones spike. That means 4 is present in ones place. So 3 is present in tens place. So write 3 first. And 4 beads are, that is 4 is present in ones place. Write 4 next. So the number is 3, 4, and it can be read as 34. And see the next one. So here also there are 2 spikes. So one is the ones spike and T means this is a tens spike. And count the number of beads in each spike and write that number in the set. So how many beads are there on 10 spike? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So Charan, 8 beads are there on the 10 spike. That means 8 is present in 10 place. And how many beads are there on 1 spike? So on 1 spike also there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in ones spike also there are 8 beads. That means 8 is present in tens place. So first write 8. And 8 is present in ones place. Again write 8 next. So the number is 88. That is 88. So children, in this way we can write the numbers from the given abacus. And there are some problems for you to practice these problems at your home. And do these problems as your homework. So children, this is the way of writing numbers from the given abacus. So let us go to the next part in this chapter. So this is also on the abacus. So children, so what is this? So draw the beads. So draw the beads to represent the number given in circle below. The children, so here the number is given in the circle. Now our task is we have to draw the beads on each spike by using that number. So in the previous one, so they have given beads, we have written the number. And in this part, they have given the number. Now we have to draw the beads, that is in opposite way. So now let us see how to draw the beads on each spike and abacus by using this number. So see the first number here. So what is the first number given here? This number is 46. This number is 46. That means 4 is present in tens place and 6 is present in ones place. So 4 is present in tens place. That means we have to draw 4 beads on tens spike. So this is a tens spike. That's why we have to keep 4 beads. 1, 2, 3, 4 beads. And 6 is present in ones place. That means we have to draw 6 beads on ones spike. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 beads. So children, in this way, so we can draw the beads on the abacus by using the number. See the next problem. So what is the second number here? 38. So here 3 is present in tens place, 8 is present in ones place. So how many tens are there? 3 tens. That means we have to draw 3 beads on tens spike. So 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 beads on tens spike. And how many ones are there? So there are 8 ones. And draw 8 beads on ones spike. So draw 8 beads, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 beads draw on the ones spike. See the next third problem here also. So what is the third number here? 91. So in this problem also, so here 9 is present in tens place. So draw 9 beads on tens spike. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And 1 is present on ones place. So draw 1 bead on ones spike. So draw 1 bead. So see the last number here, 57. So how to represent this 57 on abacus? So here children, 5 is present in tens place. So that's why draw 5 beads on tens spike. So draw 5 beads on tens spike, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 7 is present in ones place. So draw 7 beads on ones spike. So draw 7 beads, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So draw 7 beads on ones spike. So in this way, children, we can draw the beads on the abacus by using the given number. So these are the some problems on the abacus. So let us go to the next part.